No matter what you say, what you do, when I'm alone, I'd rather be with you. These other niggas, I'll be right by your side till 2005.
Okay, hold up, wait a minute. All good, just a week ago. Crew at my house, and we party every weekend, so.
Donald Glover, from comedian to actor, writer to musician, he has done it all. 11 years ago, Donald was one of the first people to gain success on YouTube while also writing for 30 Rock at the same time. Now he has his own TV show, is starring in huge theatrical movies, and recently released a new album that brought funk back. Donald keeps surprising everyone every year with the amount of talent and potential he has, so let's take a look back at Donald's life and his success. Donald Glover was born September 25th, 1983 at Edwards Air Force Base, California. Soon after, him and his parents moved to Stone Mountain, Georgia. His father, Donald Glover Sr., was a postal worker. His mother, Beverly, was a daycare provider. Donald also had two siblings, Bree and Stephen Glover. Donald was raised as a Jehovah's Witness, just like his character on Community.
I am Jehovah's most secret witness, so I might have to dedicate my life to Christmas and act just like I love it till the day I die.
Donald's parents were also foster parents for many kids.
I grew up with a bunch of kids. My mom ran a daycare, and we had foster kids, and we had adopted kids. I know kids pretty well, and I've got to be honest, kids are pretty fucked up anyway. They're awful people. They're tiny, tiny little Hitlers. All of them. They're all awful.
He graduated from DeKalb School of Arts, where we got these amazing pictures.
Girl, I make you come fast. I need come right over. Yes, a nigga so street. Call a nigga Grover. Hit it like I'm supposed to. Love it when you're smiling. Except when you're not smiling, giving my dick oral hygiene. Girlfriend, you dopey. I'm all about my Benjamins. But you stay sweet like an everlasting Enderman.
Donald was voted to be the most likely to write for The Simpsons, which is pretty ironic, as you'll see in a minute. For college, Donald went to the NYU's Tisch School of Arts, and in 2004, he freestyled this. During his time there, he met Dominic Dirks and DC Pearson, the three of which created Derek Comedy, one of the biggest and earliest successes on YouTube, creating many such classics as Bro Rape.
Cool. No, dude, what are you?
Alright, bro. Yo, this is gonna be sweet, alright? Wish me luck.
Okay? No, bro! Bro! No! Bro, stop!
It's a type of rape that's gone overlooked for decades, and it's risen 44% in the last year. I'm talking, of course, about bro rape.
And National Spelling Bee.
Your word is nigger faggot.
I'm sorry, what?
Nigger faggot.
Can I get a definition?
The definition is nigger faggot.
The channel now has over 100 million views in total. In 2005, Donald released his first mixtape, The Younger I Get, an album he disowns and has never been online or heard by the general public. In 2006, Donald graduated with a dramatic writing degree. The same year, he was contacted by David Miner, to whom he sent writing samples to, including a spec script that he had written for The Simpsons. Miner and Tina Fey were impressed by Glover's work and invited him to become a writer for the NBC series 30 Rock. Donald was a writer on the show for 3 years, while also having many cameo roles.
Jesus.
Go
concern for your butt bone. Why are you all laughing? I like it. Coccyx, coccyx. You know what this is? This is a ghetto mating call.
I have but one thing to say to all of you. Be yourself. And I'm talking to you clearly, gay kid. Who told?
Don't eat in costume. Give me a break. I'm just...
In 2008, Donald refueled his music career with Sick Boy, a 12-track mixtape, the first to be released to the general public.
Sick boys don't die, they fresh to death. My shoes break blue, so you watch my step. My hoodie hat big with their head to match. So you ain't gotta know where my paper ain't. Pop's heads, cause I'm filthy. Apes can bait me. My home is the dirty, but I shine like crazy. My hat tag up, and it hang off slightly. My game 8-bit, so your niggas can bite me.
You can still find it and listen to it today. Although the biggest criticism of the mixtape is his voice, in which he raps in a nasally, almost sick-like tone.
I'm a weird dude, but you like me. Give other girls shots like Nikes. I know I'm always on the road, you can type me. And if you don't do that, you can skate me. I'm a big kid, and you know that. But it don't make me happy, so we blow that. Can I make time? I don't really know. Just to see pissed off when the go to shows. I never really had a girl like this, but I ain't never had a girl who can keep interest. The things that I do, the things that I want to be. I know I'm hard-headed, can't see things in front of me. I'm gonna be the best, you can believe that. Just try and understand when I have to leave that. When I'm done, I'ma give you the call. Don't you know, sugar, you my sugar baby doll, doll.
His stage name, Childish Gambino, came from a Wu-Tang Clan's name generator, which you can still use today. 2009 was a big year for Donald. In February 2009, he and the crew of 30 Rock was presented an award for the best comedy series for their work on the third season of 30 Rock.
And the Emmy goes to 30 Rock.
He also released a movie with Derek Comedy called Mystery Team.
Excuse me, is this the principal's office?
Come in, Jason.
I am not Jason. I am Jason's father.
Jason, take off the mustache.
We meet again, old friend.
We're the Mystery Team. My name's Jason, the master of the sky.
I'm Duncan, the boy genius.
And I'm Charlie, the strongest kid in town.
Ow!
All we need is one big case before people start respecting us again, like they did when we were 7.
People respect us.
Fuck yourselves!
Faggots. Hi, are you the Mystery Team?
What can we do for you, ma'am?
Just fill out this form real quick.
Can you find out who killed my parents?
And Donald Glover became more known to the public with the premiere of Community, a television show about a group of people in community college. Donald played Troy Barnes, a former high school quarterback who leaves his jock persona for a more nerdy, childish side as a result of his friendship with Abed.
We really appreciate you doing this.
Sure.
And 3, 2, 1. Troy and Abed in the morning, and we're back. Look who's here, Jeff Winger.
Jeff, how do you stay so fit?
Diet, exercise, genetics.
Sure.
Okay, so it seems as though we have a clip. You want to set it up for us?
I'd like to, but I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, we'll just roll it.
Ooh, my name's Jeff Winger. Ooh.
Hey, I'm Jeff Winger. I'm so tall.
This watch is expensive.
Muscles are everywhere.
Oh, that was really funny.
Guys, what's going on? Where are the cameras?
Oh, we're not filming this.
Now, who'd want to watch this?
Oh, guys, it's 6 a.m. Jeez.
We're not going to have him back.
Troy and Abed in
no!
the...
The same day as Community premiered, Donald released his second mixtape, Poindexter.
I ain't your ordinary nigga. Look around, this ain't what ordinary gets ya. I ain't your ordinary nigga. Look around, this ain't what ordinary gets ya. Sunshine, oh, baby girl, oh, it's on my mind.
Donald had another massive year in 2010. In early 2010, Donald released another mixtape, I Am Just a Rapper.
Sick boy make moves like a chess piece. And I move real quick like Nestle. Let me make it clear for a second like Pepsi. I was never worried about my wallet being empty. Cause when it was empty, I was still happy. Walking with my Walkman, freestyle rapping. High school bullies like, what the fuck happened? Nigga off the hook like I fucking shot the captain. And this is me relaxing, rapping is my hobby. I did this in my bedroom where I separate my laundry. Watching old episodes of Shining Time Station. You are now listening to my mouth on vacation.
And shortly after, he released another mixtape, I Am Just a Rapper 2.
Yes, I'm back with a whole new attitude. Flyer than a cardinal, check my fucking latitude. Yes, I'm so sick, man, somebody call a doctor. Girl, stay wet like I'm fucking with a lobster. I stopped talking, I'm tired of paying them lip service. Switched over them street niggas to hipsters. I am so different, Donald Glover in this bitch. I don't need to use my rapper name, that's just childish. And they used to call me Oreo, dunk me in that milk. Maybe then I will be white enough to hang out with them kids. They have to call you names when they don't know what you are. Now they know just what I are, baby girl, I am a star.
Both of which had songs he rapped over. Donald also had a stand-up special that aired on Comedy Central. In May of that year, a fan suggested that he should play Spider-Man in the up-and-coming Amazing Spider-Man movie. The campaign, hashtag Donald for Spider-Man, went viral and even got Stan Lee to support him. Glover never got an audition and revealed later that he wasn't even contacted by anyone from Sony Pictures. Because of the campaign, Miles Morales, the African-American Spider-Man that premiered in 2011, his appearance was influenced by Donald Glover. Luckily, Donald will later voice this Spider-Man on the Ultimate Spider-Man animated series.
Whoa, I'm not you. You're dead, which makes me dead. No way, neither of us could be dead. That's impossible, Peter Parker. So you're not dead?
I'm not what now?
Okay, don't freak out.
Huh?
My name is Miles Morales, and I'm Spider-Man. We're not ghosts, right? Because if I'm dead, my mom and dad are gonna kill me.
You're Spider-Man? But you're so young.
What are you gonna do, card me? I'm 13, almost 14 in 11 months.
In July, Donald released his fifth mixtape, Cul-de-sac. Donald's production on the last song that you heard, Do Ya Like, brought him much praise. Cul-de-sac was the first time Donald was personal with his audience, something that'll continue throughout his career.
I get emotional when I order that dessert, cause she always ate dessert, and I deserted her. But I refuse to compromise career for a girl, cause this music and this writing and this acting is my soul. And if I let it go, there'd be no one left to know. Being happy is the goal, but greatness is my vision. And all these girls are thinking they compete with my ambition. But baby, I am different. This shit is my life. And if you don't believe me, you can never be my wife. I'm walking in this darkness and I'm trying to find a light. And I'd rather die than the average, and chances are I might.
And it was also the first time Donald would collaborate with his now long-term music partner, Ludwig Göransson. That same month, Donald received the Rising Comedy Star Award, and later that year, he was featured in a Gap ad. In 2011, Donald released dates for his first tour, as well as a music video for Freaks and Geeks.
Alright, Gambino is a mastermind. Fuck a bitch to pass the time. Mass appeal, orange rind. Smoke your green, I'm spending mine. The beat is witch's brew. But beware, this shit is potent. E.E. coming on her face. Now there's poetry in motion.
In March, he released his Be Alone EP. Donald also released another comedy special called Weirdo.
I was walking down the street in LA. I was walking down the street from my restaurant, from one of my favorite restaurants, and I had like a bag full of food. And
it's right across the street from school. And I saw two kids fighting over a basketball. They're like, fighting over it and just walking by. And and one of them just goes, and just pulls it. And the other one goes, that's why your mom's in a wheelchair. And I dropped my shit. I was like,
a couple months later, Donald announced his first album, and in July, he announced the name to be Camp. Donald released the music video for Bonfire in September.
Okay, it's Childish Gambino, homegirl dropping like the NASDAQ. Move white girls like this coat up my ass crack. Move black girls, cause man, fuck it, I'll do either. I love pussy, I love bitches, dude, I should be running Peter in Adidas with some short shorts. B-O-O-R over me, my green is where it's supposed to be. Your green is in my grocery. This Asian dude, I stole his girl, and now he got that Koji beef. My dick is like an accent mark, it's all about the overeat.
And he released the album November 15th. The most popular song on the album was Heartbeat.
So we're done? This the real shit? We used to hold hands like field trips. I'm a jerk, but your dude is a real dick. I read his posts on your wall and I feel sick. He ain't cool, he ballin' all that, but he just a fake nigga who blogging all cats. You couldn't wait today. I'm going straight for your thighs like the cake you ate. I give a fuck about the niggas that you say you ate. You know that I'm the best when I'ma fake your name. I'm the best that you had, face it. Jay and Keisha are related, racist. I give you money that you burning that you made off. She ain't a killer, but you fucking blow your head off. I know he wondering what the fuck you hiding. That we dated like rats about Bin Laden. Hey yo, fuck this. Are we dating? Are we fucking? Are we best friends? Are we something in between that? I wish we never fucked, and I mean that.
But not really. You say the nastiest shit in bed, and it's fucking awesome.
The album got an average of 69% out of 100. Most reviewers enjoyed it, except one from Pitchfork who gave it a 1.6 out of 10. A month after releasing the album, Donald had a duet with Danny Putty, the actor of Abed, and they released Troy and Abed's Christmas Rap.
Yoip, going deep, cover past enemy lines, making everybody think I'm on the Christmas side. Rockin' warm sweaters, hanging big ass lights. If the fat man can see me, yo, it's gotta look right. I watch all the TV specials that I never could. I'll even cry during the sad ones like James Bond would. And when the big night comes, it's time to set the bait. Cold milk, hot cookies, decorative plates. And he'll come down the chimney and it will be just him and me. But he won't know we're enemies, cause I'll play sincere. Bring a trap like that, hug him tight, get on his lap, and tell him he can come back every year.
In July 2012, Donald released another mixtape called Royalty.
When I'm alone in my room, sometimes I stare at the wall. And in the back of my mind, I hear my conscience call. I used to front something stupid, now I'm making them wait. Except for you, mama, I'm ready, I don't wanna be late. Never hesitate, you know it. Petty cash, we blow it. Excuse me for imperfect, them halfway looks is worth it. I watch these niggas lurking, they just want my leftovers. Watching locked up all day and slept over.
With many features like Schoolboy Q and his brother, who raps under the name Steve G Lover. In November, Ludwig hinted at a new album that would be bigger with more people involved. And around 2012 and 2013, Donald met Chance the Rapper, and they collaborated on a couple of songs.
It's my jam, it's my jam, it's my jam, it's my jam. It's that jam, it's that jam, it's that jam, it's that jam, it's that jam.
Niggas, please be focused. That Beano, you know this. He rapped the home of Sosa's. You know I'm from that zone 6. You know I rep that stone shit. You know your hood is so clear as God. As my witness, this Will Smith spit real shit. I'ma be that. CG busy getting where the weed at. Bought your girl some new knee pads. You're fucking with me, Fifi bag. My stars, E-Gat. She said, it's my favorite song. Hold my purse. Now she on the float, dropping like it's high.
In 2013, Donald signed on to create a new music-themed show for FX titled Atlanta, which he acts, writes, and executively produces. At the same time, Donald reduced his work for NBC, only appearing in 5 episodes of Community's 5th season before leaving.
Captain Barnes, we should probably set sail while the wind is still in our favor, don't you think?
Engage.
A gathering of angels appearing above my head.
Now, Troy, I know it's going to be difficult for you to interact with me.
No, no, that was the original, Troy. I'm his clone. Let's get the light out, Bert.
Aye, aye, sir.
Come sail away with me, lads. Come sail away, come sail away, come sail away with me.
Donald also released Clapping for the Wrong Reasons, a short film that sets up his screenplay Because the Internet, which is a continuation of the story at the end of That Power. The screenplay also coincides with his album titled Because the Internet. You can still find and read the screenplay today. Shortly after announcing his album Because the Internet in October, he posted a ton of pictures onto Instagram, expressing his fears and feelings. Later that October, he released the single for 3005.
I used to care what people thought, but now I care more, and nobody out here's got it figured out. So therefore, I've lost all hope of a happy ending, depending on whether or not it's worth it. So insecure, no one's perfect, we spend it with no shame. We blow that like Coltrane, we in here like Rogaine, or leave it like Cobain. And when I'm long gone, whole crew singing swan song, cause we all just ticking time bombs. Got a Lambo like LeBron's mom, and no matter where all of my friends go, Emily, fam, and Lorenzo, all of them people my kinfolk, at least I think so. Can't tell, cause when them checks clear, they're not here, cause they don't care. It's kinda sad, but I'm laughing. Whatever happens, assassins are staffed in the back of my cabin. Labrador yapping, I'm glad that it happened. I mean it, between us, I think there's something special. And if I lose my mental, just hold my hand, even if you don't understand. Hold up.
Donald released his second album December 10th, 2014, with many songs like
Bought a new bag, 8K nigga. Wanna take shots, 8K nigga. When I ball, I'ma ball King James nigga. Uncle Ben in my hand make change nigga. And I'm out of this world like Tang nigga. That's a space bar, man, I hate y'all. You only come around when you wanna play pool or my hot tub. Ice cream paint job in the garage. I had a Minaj and murdered the Vaj. But afterwards, it was awkward as fuck. Cause I'm nervous as fuck. You cannot get it up. I need a minute. Cold water to the face. I couldn't finish. Got the Uber from a place on my porch, smoking vapor. Hit with the Sunday paper. Listening to the neighbors.
And
watching haters wonder why Gambino got the game. Half tie thicky, all she wanna do is bang. Got her head done, French braids, now she ASAP. Bino so insensitive, she asking why you say that. I'm chilling, real nigga feeling. Rich kid asshole, paint me as a villain. Still spitting that cash flow, DJ Khaled. I got penthouse on both coasts, PH balance. Real nigga, I rep those. Why though? Cause I said so. Dip deep in that Pepto, I got five on it like Ben. I got more tail than that Petco. You faker than some sweet and low. Yeah, you got some silverware, but really, are you eating though?
The album got 64% out of 100. In early 2014, Donald began his deep web tour. June of that year, Donald's song Heartbeat was certified gold, and a month later, 3005 was also certified gold. In October, he released Stone Mountain.
To love you all the time. I don't have words for this part, but I know it should sound like this. To love you all the time.
And the next day he released the EP Kawaii.
Girl, what's your problem? Cause I know it's hard sometimes. Maybe just give it some time. Oh honey now girl, we can solve them. If you just give me some time, I can open up your mind. If you let it shine, you can free your mind. Cause I know.
Donald was mostly out of the limelight for most of 2015, except for starring in The Martian. In 2016, Because the Internet was certified gold in February, and later that year was certified platinum. Over the summer, Donald released an app called Ferris Earth, which was a way to purchase tickets to a listening event for his new album. The listening event was held in September, right before Donald's premiere of his television show, Atlanta.
What? My breath.
I love it. What is that? Curry?
Are you kidding?
It's like a very deep curry.
That is not, that's like some freaky shit.
Hey, yo, you heard that new Paperboy mixtape?
That's my cousin.
You gonna wanna get in there before he gets signed, man.
So, zoo tycoon.
You want in on Paperboy?
What? No?
Please, man.
If we do this right, your kids can live good. My kids can live good.
No, this is a great environment for you.
Atlanta was nominated and won a Golden Globe for the Best Comedy Television Series, and Donald also won Best Actor in a Comedy Series. Because of the success of the show, FX signed Donald to an exclusive deal to create and develop more shows. The first of these shows is an animated version of Deadpool that Donald and his brother are writing. A couple months after the listening party in September, he released his newest album, Awaken My Love, with songs like Me and Your Mama, and Redbone. The album was unlike anything he's released before, bringing an almost funk-like vibe back. The album got an average rating of 77%, and even spawned a meme called Redbone, but it's... During early 2017, during Donald's Golden Globe speech, he announced that he had a child early 2016, and that he was a boy. In June of 2017, Donald revealed his son's name before performing Baby Boy.
This song is dedicated to everybody in this crowd and my young son legend.
And right before his performance ended, Donald announced one last Gambino album.
Thank you.
A couple days after the concert, Donald revealed to Huffington Post what his thoughts were about his music career.
At the Governor's Ball, that this is going to be your last album. Can you elaborate on that a little bit? Because we were so sad, and it's like, you know, you got to keep doing it for you and maybe even your family too. Like,
I believe in endings. I don't think, like, people are really scared of death. I am not afraid of that shit. That's part of life. That's part of everything. Like, if anything went, like, you know, that kind of, like, that thing of just, like, would God make a stone that he himself could not pick up? That kind of riddle. It's like, yeah, he could, but why would he do that? Like, kind of thing. Like, everything needs to have a balance. And I don't think making things go on to the point where they're not, like, I believe businesses should have a death clause. I honestly do. If you're not fulfilling the thing that you started to do, and now you've become something else, like, McDonald's is about real estate. It's not about burgers. No one gives, they don't give a fuck. There's like, so, it's like, if you're not making the product that you set out to do, why are you doing it anymore? So like I just feel like with Redbone, with all the things I try and do, that I try and make them punk. With Redbone, I felt like that was a punk move because it's a gospel song that we got on the radio.
Yeah.
And
which is huge.
Thanks. Yeah, I'm really happy about it. But I'm like, there's only so far you can go into pop before you're just pop. So yeah.
Recently, there has been many rumors about his new album, as well as his collab project with Chance the Rapper. In July of 2017, Donald starred as Aaron Davis in Spider-Man Homecoming, which is actually the uncle of Miles Morales. Donald is also set to play Lando Calrissian in the 2018 Han Solo film. And John Ferrero announced a remake of The Lion King, with Donald starring as the voice of Simba. Lastly, the second season of Atlanta will be released sometime 2018. So Donald Glover really is a true Renaissance man. From a comedian, writer, actor, musician, to even directing an episode of his television show, Donald has grown so much. 11 years ago, he was an ambitious 22-year-old leaving college. Now he's one of the most influential and biggest names in the entertainment industry. And while I couldn't cover everything about his life, I tried to compile everything cohesively. So before we end, let's go through a montage of his career.
Wish upon the moon, sweet light. Let's all sing a song tonight.
Is the scientific term for your butt bone.
No, I don't know what to do. My whole brain is crying.
That's real detective stuff.
You're not a real detective.
I'm finishing this case.
Hey, you guys want to get dry fucked?
No, we're okay.
Yeah, we're good.
Screaming, crying. So I'm like, why was I like? It was like the end of the movie Seven and shit. Everybody's crying. Morgan Freeman was there. He's like, oh, how can someone do this? Like, everyone's going nuts. I've never seen this many adults cry in my entire life.
Kill beef, go ham. These rappers are afraid of him, cause I'm a beast, bitch, girl. Invaders him. Gambino is a call girl. Fuck you, pay me. Brand new whip for these niggas like slavery. Told me I was awful and that shit did not faze me. Tell me how I suck again, my memory is hazy. You're my favorite rapper now, yeah, dude, I better be. Or you can fucking kiss my ass, human centipede.
What's your favorite verse written by any other rapper?
I really like the rap lyric by Eminem. That's kind of like, I just like the way it's like, he's like, sorry, Puff, but I don't give a fuck. If she was my own mother, I'd still fuck her with no rubber and come. It's just like how silly that rhyme is and how fast he goes.
That is the.
I think you're being really
unfair. You're being sensitive.
I'll kill you, Childish Gambino. You smell like dog
shit. It seems like you don't like me. I wrote that.
Yeah, it's on my album.
Like we didn't have any space. We had like no room, so we had to sleep in my room, so he sleep in my bed. And he was like, I remember in the morning when we woke up, like he was like, let's rub butts. And I was like, I just did it. I was like, okay, like I don't know what that means, like I don't really get it. And then when we turned, and when I turned, like he kissed me. Kiss you? Yeah.
See.
to me. Oh, honey, now, girl, give it one night. If you'll just give it a chance, loving you is not my plan. Can't really explain it. I'm so into you. I really like what you've done to me. Can't really explain it.
If we do this right, your kids can live good. My kids can live good.
What? No, this is a great environment for you.
I'll see you for the last Gambino album.